Hi friends, welcome to our channel. Up to now we have discussed binary classification, that means we are handling only two classes. Now we will move to multi-class classification, that means it contains a many number of classes. Whenever we have to predict, it contains many number of classes. Before going how to perform multi-class classification, first I will explain one point. Suppose in binary classification, how we measure the performance? The performance is measured by using confusion matrix. The performance is measured by using confusion matrix, or another name is contingency table. Another name is a contingency table. By using this one, we are calculating the performance. Here performance means either accuracy or precision or recall. But in multi-class classification, how we are measuring this performance? Simply assume if we are using a K-class classification, that means we have K number of classes. We have K number of classes, then simply construct a K by K matrix. Then construct a K by K matrix or K by K table to measure the performance, that is accuracy, precision and recall. Suppose consider one simple example of matrix. We already know the column specify the predicted values, column specify the predicted values, rows specify the actual value, predicted value and actual value. Consider any example. For example, assume a 3 class, that is the value of k is equal to 3. Any number, suppose 15, 7, 2. 15, 7, 2. These are some predicted values. This is class 1, this is another class, this is some other class. Suppose 2, 15, and 3. Suppose 3, 8, 45. Any assumption, for example, these are different classes. 20, these are margins. We already know margins is the sum of all the values. 45, 47, 49. Suppose these are the margins. 2, 3, 45 and 50. Suppose sum of these one 15, 22, 24 and 15, 18, 20 and 56. The total are 100. For example, consider any instance. We already know how to calculate accuracy. Accuracy means simply the sum of diagonal elements by total number of instances, the sum of descending diagonals. That means, for example, in this case, these are the correct prediction. For this one, this is the correct prediction. For this one, this is the correct prediction. 15 plus 15, 30, 30 plus 45, 75, 75 by 100. That is 75% is the accuracy. 75% is the accuracy. And similarly, 15 by 24, 15 by 24 is the precision for class 1. For class 1, 15 by 20 is the precision for class 2, 45 by 56 is the precision for class 3. So, precision means the correct predicted value by the total number of predictions. Similarly, recall means 15 by 20 is the recall for the first class, 15 by 30 is the recall for the second class, 45 by 50 is the correct recall for the third class. Simply sum is the average of all these classes is the precision or recall for the entire class. This is just an introduction part. That is, in this way we measure the performance. Now we will move to multi-class classification. How do we construct multi-class classification? Before constructing, assume we have only a binary classifier. That is, our aim is, that is, we have the ability to train only two classes. To train only two classes, that is, a linear classifier. Then by using linear classifier, how we are divide the multi-class classification. You got the point? That means we have the ability to train only two classes. Only two classes. But our aim is to provide multiple number of classes. How we train? For this purpose. For this purpose, I am using two schemes. One is one versus rest. And another one is one versus one. By using these two schemes, I am converting my binary classification into multi-classification. My binary classification into binary classification. First, we will discuss one versus rest. Assume we have k number of classes. Assume we have some k number of classes or some n number of classes. C1, C2 and so on. Some n number of classes. C1, C2 and so on. CN are the classes. How to we train? The name itself specifies one versus rest. That means first class is considered as positive. Simple terms, this one class is considered as positive, the remaining all are considered as negative. That is, the first one separates class C1 from remaining all classes. Suppose if you want to calculate second one, C1, C2 and so on, CN. This is one class. The second one separates class C2 from remaining all classes. That is, C2 is one, remaining all are other one. For example, if you want to find, calculate CI classifier. This CI is one entry. Remaining all are belongs to other entries. That is simple assumption. This CI contains all positive entries. CI contains all positive entries. Remaining all contains negative entries. That is the one versus rest. That is one. And remaining one as considered as other one. Similarly, suppose in this one versus rest, before going to that one, I am discussing one more point. One versus one. One versus rest means you got the point. One and the remaining all are same. One and remaining all are same. Similarly, one versus one. That means we have to consider each pair. C1, C2 is one pair. C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, C8. We have to consider pair by pair. Suppose C1, C2 is considered, C3, C4 is considered. Again, this pair and this pair. We have to consider in each pairwise manner. And suppose if you want to perform one versus rest, we have to try K-1 models. Suppose if you are following the fixed order, we have to train K-1 models. Assume, for example, we have K classes. I am fixing the first one and the remaining are K-1. I am fixing the second one, remaining are K-1. Fixing the third one, remaining are K-1. Then we have to train K-1 models. That means in one versus one. We have to consider each pair of classifiers. And if you are following either order or unordered, that is, if you are using either symmetric or asymmetric. Asymmetric means C1 is different from C1, C2. The pair is different from C2, C1. C1, C2, this is different from C2, C1. If you are using the pairs, K into K-1/2. If you are following symmetry, that is C1, C2 and C2, C1 are assumed as equal. In that case, we have to train K into K-1/2 models. Suppose if you are using asymmetry, that is, if you are assuming these two are different, then we have to train K into K-1 models. This is the just introduction. The two schemes are 1 versus rest, 1 versus 1. In simple term, 1 versus rest means one class separates the remaining all other classes. 1 versus 1 means each pair is considered as a classifier. Now, how to describe this in terms of matrices? So the concept is clear, but to identify a new instance, whenever new instance comes, how to predict the class for that new instance? Now, this entire concept is represented in. Now, transform this three class task into output code matrix. That is, the matrix, each column is a binary classification task. Each column contains a binary classification task. It contains only the values plus 1, 0 and minus 1. First we will move to 1 versus 1. Suppose how to represent 1 versus 1 in output code matrix. In everything we have two cases. One is ordered, second one is unordered. That is, we have symmetric case and asymmetric case. We have three classes, C1, C2, C3. The first one is, C1 is the positive, C2, C3 are the negative. In 1 versus 1, we are considering this pair, C1, C2 or C1, C3 or C2, C3. C1, C2, C2, C3 or C1, C3. These are the pairs. For suppose if you are considering C1 and C2, so my assumption is, suppose C1 is the positive, C2 is the negative. What about C3? C3 is simply ignored. Suppose consider this pair and this pair. Suppose this pair, C1 is the positive and C3 is the negative, this one, and the C2 is ignored. Suppose in this pair, C1 is ignored, C2 is the positive and C3 is negative. This is the concept of 1 versus 1. Concept of 1 versus 1, and this is a symmetric case. This is symmetric case. Asymmetric case means we have to consider each one. That is, C1, C2 is different from C2, C1. C2, C3 is different from C3, C2. Is different from C1, C3. That means C1 positive, C2 negative. Then we have one more case, C1 negative, C2 positive. That means simply the symmetric case add 3 more rows. That is, just swap the classes, plus 1, minus 1, 0. C1 positive, C2 negative. Swap the case, C1 negative, C2 positive. Similarly for this one, plus 1, 0, minus 1, swap this one, minus 1, 0, plus 1, 0, plus 1, minus 1, swap this one, 0, minus 1, plus 1. This is symmetric case, this is asymmetric case. These are the output code matrix for 1 versus 1. In 1 versus 1, we consider pair by pair, okay, it is clear. Next, I will move to 1 versus rest. In 1 versus rest case, again I will draw the matrix. What are the cases? C1, C2, C3. If C1 is considered as a positive, C2, C3 is negative. If C2 is a positive, C1, C3 is negative. If C3 is a positive, C1, C2 is a negative. 1 versus rest means 1 is considered as a positive examples, remaining all are considered as negative examples. Suppose the matrix is C1 is a positive. Suppose my assumption C1, C2, C3. C1 is a positive and the remaining 2 are negative. If C2 is the positive, remaining 2 are negative. If C3 is the positive, remaining 2 are negative. This is unordered case. Suppose, what do you mean by ordered? Order case means C1, C2, C3. We have to follow the fixed order. That is, consider the pair. First, the pair C1, C2, C3 is 1, 1. Suppose C2, we have to consider C3 only. Suppose we are at C1, we have to consider C2 and C3. We are at C2, consider C3 only, ignore C1. Suppose the matrix is C1, C2, C3. If I am considering C1 as a positive and C2, C3 are the negatives. Suppose second one is, if I am using C2, ignore this one. That means we are follow a fixed order, 0 for C1. C2 is the positive, C3 is the negative. This is order. This is one versus rest scheme. Now we had constructed the code matrix for one versus one and one versus rest. And what is our final task? Whenever a new instance come, how to predict the particular class? To predict the class by using this code instances, that is by using this code matrix. Okay, similarly in that also, plus 1 means for positive, minus 1 means negative, 0 means rejected. Plus 1 means the class is positive, minus 1 means negative, 0 means rejected. For example, consider a what? Minus 1, 0, plus 1. Consider a word minus 1, 0, plus 1 or anything. For example, we have a simple example. Suppose I consider a word minus 1, plus 1, minus 1. This is my example. All these together as considered as a word. This is the new instance. Check whether the new instance belongs to which class. Our aim is to which class this new instance belongs. In that case, first we have to fix which technique we are using. That is one versus one or one versus rest. Suppose if we are using one versus rest. If I am using one versus rest, identify the row which matches this one. Minus one, plus one, minus one. Observe. Minus one, plus one, minus one. It is similar to this one. So my word belongs to class C2. Okay, it is clear. Suppose if the exact match is not available, what we will do? If exact match is not available, for example, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, what we will do? In that cases, we have to identify the nearest words. How to calculate the nearest code words? The concept is clear. So what is my concept in multi-class classification? By using linear, that is by using binary classification, I am constructing multi-class classification. I have two ways. One is one versus one and another one is one versus rest. The one versus one is converted into code matrix. At the same time, one versus rest is also converted into code matrix. So input schemes are completed. Now my aim is, whenever a new instance comes, we have to identify for which class this instance belongs to. So simply this word is checked in the matrix. If it is available, then that particular class, the instance belongs to the particular class. If the word is not available, then we have to find the distance between, this word and all the words in the code matrix. Which one has the lowest distance? Which one has the nearest or lowest distance? The word belongs to that class. I will explain the formula how to calculate the distance. For example, distance of W comma CI. W is the word, that is the instance what we were checking. CI is all the instances present in the matrix, is equal to sigma 1 minus WI CI by 2. By using this formula, we are calculating the distances. Suppose we are calculating WC1, WC2, WC3. Among all these one, which has the minimum value? For example, assume C2, this one has the minimum value. Now our ward belongs to class C2. In this multiplication, one term, if one ward is plus 1, another ward is minus 1. Suppose that the multiplication, one is plus 1, one contribution, another one is minus 1. Simply it contributes to plus 1. If any of one entry is 0, these are the two entries. If two entries, one is plus 1 and another one is minus 1, the contribution is plus 1, that is the result is. If any one of the entries is 0, irrespective of the second entry, the contribution is off. That is, in this multiplication, we are using these formulas. Calculating these examples. In this way, we are calculating the distance between the ward, and the code matrix, and which has the minimum, we are predicted that class as our required class. Okay, clear. Up to now, we have discussed three class classifier. How many number of classes we are considering? Three class classifier. For example, if we are using four class classifier, that means we have four number of classes. At the time of calculating distance, if two classes are predicted as a positive and two classes are predicted as negative, that is, in three class classifier means generally we have one has a majority, either two are positive, one is negative, or two are negative, one is a positive. But in even case, if two are predicted as a positive, two are predicted as a negative, then this approach also leads to failure. Then by using this approach also, it is difficult to identify for which class the ward belongs to. In that cases, what our binary classifiers do? Binary classifier calculate scores. So generally the highest score, that is a positive score, represents the positive class, negative score represents the negative class. We already know we are calculating a margin z. Suppose Si into Cji. Based on this margin, suppose the positive margin means the correct predictions, negative margin means incorrect predictions, and these margins are fed to a loss function. We already discussed in binary classification the same procedure: calculate the score for each and every class and identify the margins. If the positive margin represents correct predictions and negative margins represents incorrect predictions, and all these margins are fed to a large loss function. Now, what is the loss function? The loss function maps these margin examples to the loss functions. For example, distance of S, Cj. That is, the distances are calculated by using scores also. S, Cj is equal to, we are calculating the loss function, Si, Cji. We are mapping this distance into loss function. The lowest value of loss function means the lowest distance. That is, for that instance belongs to the class which has the lowest distance. This is called multi-class classification. Thank you.